Hey, welcome back to Mental Game Secrets They Don't Want You to Know About. So thank you again for being here. I'm David Breslow, founder of Performance Success Strategies and creator of Wired to Win, the most effective performance model on the tennis market today. So as you heard in the intro, this is not your traditional model because we go right to the end, and the end is what you truly desire, which is to play your best, not continually keep preparing to prepare to prepare to be your best, but actually be your best. And as you listen to these lessons and you apply what you hear, you are literally bypassing all that other stuff and literally getting to a position where you can start to be your best right now. So let's get right into today's secret they don't want you to know. And this has to do with why things and tips and other things that you try don't really seem to work, or if they work, they're very temporary. And I really want to talk to you for a moment about one of the biggest mistakes I think tennis players are making. And so as always, please take notes on what you hear. And so here we go, let's dive in. If your matches are filled with you trying really hard to deal with obstacles and inner demons, such as negativity, anger, frustration, harmful reactions, lack of confidence, and more, and in your efforts to overcome them, you apply what are called coping mechanisms, you are making the game very, very difficult. You have given in to the myth that tennis or any other sport is where you are supposed to deal with or manage things. You see, traditional models believe in this too. The idea is that they want to help you manage and deal with harmful issues that come up during play. Seems to make sense, right? But it really doesn't. These issues are things like your negative reactions to poor shots, bad bounces, bad luck, bad line calls, missed opportunities, poor choices that you might make, and any number of things that you might face during play. So here's the flaw in that approach. It's very simple. You see, the traditional approach wants to load you down with what are called coping mechanisms. It's really more and more and more junk to think about, more weight to carry around. And see, they think that's normal, to allow your performance fires, that's what I call them, to allow those fires to pop up, because they, probably like you, assume that they will. So then you get to apply all your little cool new coping mechanisms and tips and strategies, and that's if you can remember them all. Really, that's really not the way to go. It's a joke. That's not normal. Although they think it is, and you may think it is, I'm telling you right now, that's not normal. To wait till your fires show up and then get good at dealing with them after they show up, that's not normal. What it is, it's just an accepted way of doing things that you may have bought into, and it is flawed. Let me prove it to you. Take a dictionary, and when you're done listening to this, go look in a dictionary and look up the word cope, C-O-P-E. And in that definition, you look for the synonyms for the word cope. Here's what you're going to find: to deal with, to manage, to get by, to struggle with, and my all-time favorite, to survive. Now, when I tell people this, I look at them and say, is that really what you aspire to do? Is that your goal on the tennis court? You want to get really good at dealing with stuff, at managing stuff, at getting by and struggling and surviving? 98% of the tennis players I talk to say, hey, no, that's not my goal. But you don't realize that's what you're doing. Here's the inherent problem in this mindset of coping. Here's the problem. Basically, without saying it out loud, you've resigned. You've resigned yourself to the fact that whatever your fires are, whatever issues you have, they're going to show up. You basically resigned. You've given in and said, hey, they're going to happen. I know they're going to happen. So I guess if I know they're going to happen, I better arm myself with a bunch of weapons and ways to deal with them. Do you hear what that sounds like? That's very, very weak. Wired to Win is not interested in helping you become a better coper. I do not want you to be a better coper. Here's my question to you. I'm kind of known for this question in many different areas. The question is, once people tell me about their issues and all the troubles they go through on the court and so on, my question is, you want more tips and strategies to put out those fires, or would you rather have fewer fires to put out? Everybody I ask that question to says, well, if I had a choice, I'd rather have fewer fires. Well, guess what? You do have a choice. It's just that you've fallen into the myth that putting out fires is normal. I'm telling you, it's not. Think about it. It's way too late. Why should you get good at putting out fires after they've already occurred? There's no strength in that. There's much more strength in having far fewer fires to put out than being good at dealing with them after they already happened. Think about how silly that really is. So test yourself. Take a look. I'm going to ask you a couple questions here. Do you like playing this way? Do you enjoy playing a match where you're busy putting out fires time after time after time? I'm pretty sure that's not the way you really want to play if you could help it. Second question, do you think you're consistently better? Are you a consistently better player playing consistent tennis because you cope? And most players will say, not really. And the third question, do you continue coping with the same things over and over? Be honest. Are you coping now with many of the same issues that you were having to face and deal with, there's that phrase again, and manage last year, 6 months ago, 12 months ago, 18 months ago, 3 years ago? Because most players are getting better at coping with these fires, but they're still coping with them. So today's lesson is really more to open your mind, open your eyes, and let you know that this myth is flawed, okay? The traditional model is based on that. You go talk to many sports psychologists or a traditional coaching model, they're putting out fires. They'll ask you what your issues are, and they'll give you some tips and strategies to deal with them. Like I said, I'm not interested in helping you be a better coper. There's no strength in that. I want you to have fewer fires to cope with. And when you really do have a fire, here's what's going to happen. You'll be able to use all of your resources to really deal with and manage those big fires that might arise. The problem is that most tennis players are trying to do that with all these other fires, and it's way too hard. It's way too hard. Wouldn't you rather play a tennis match much freer? Wouldn't you rather play a match where you don't have these fires popping up so often? That's much freer, isn't it? So answer these questions. Do you really enjoy playing this way, knowing that you have to cope every time something happens? Are you consistently a better player because of your coping skills? Do you continue coping with the same kinds of issues over and over again? Like I said, be honest. Because as we move on here in this lesson series, you're going to get some really cool things to apply that are going to help you reduce the number of fires that you experience. And that is really going to be cool for you. So that's today's lesson. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. I look forward to talking to you real soon. Take care.